right, so we just got to the beginnings of the North Shore area. You can start to tell a little bit because there's a few hotels here, but they're like locally run, smaller scale hotels. Nothing too big. And so we're looking for the corn.
I know where the corn is.
No, Johnny knows where the corn is. Sinkahuku. So there's some North Shore swells coming in over there. Still pretty good, considering it's starting to get into winter. This is kind of the time of the year you would start to expect to see a little bit of transition to South Shore swells. But North Shore always has a little bit of something. Except for kind of, I guess, what, like December or something.
Oh, this is the time that it starts picking up over here.
Oh, yeah, summer swells are South Shore swells. I had it backwards. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, so winter.
In January, these are going to be huge over here.
Winter, I had that backwards. So winter is North Shore swells. Summer is South Shore swells. So the waves are starting to transition to this side of the island. And they'll get bigger and bigger and bigger until like January, when they'll be the big North Shore swells that you see like in surfing commercials and on like.
Competition.
Yeah, the competitions kind of all take off and all that stuff. So. Yeah, they're starting to look pretty good though. There's definitely some out there. We should see some surfers here coming up, and maybe around this bend. I don't know.
We're not even close to Haleiwa.
But
is that where you think we're at?
No, I don't think we're in Haleiwa yet.
Okay.
But I think you'll see surfers though. We are on the North Shore of the island now. Those are big swells, man. They don't look like super rideable though out there. But sure enough, got some bodyboarders out here.
We went to one of the North Shore beaches and we were just like jumping in the waves. My friend and I. And they were pretty big waves. Just to like jump in.
Uh-huh.
Like, you could do it for a little while, and then
you were, like, it's actually really shallow out there. That dude's standing. That guy's standing in the water, like almost 100 yards out.
It might be fishing.
That's what he was doing.
Lots of locals like camping and stuff at all these little beach parks.
Yep. Yeah, there's been lots of camping going on.
Touristy places.
Yep. This is coming up on the Polynesian Cultural Center, and they apparently have a massive marketplace now and a whole outside deal you can visit without even having to go into the PCC. But it's actually really, really good if you want to learn about the different kinds of Polynesian culture. They've got some great stuff, some great like walkthrough villages you can go to, some good shows. They've got a night show that's kind of like a musical, that's really, really good. We went to it.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoyed it a lot. Did you have fun when we were there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of touristy, but it's really neat. You learn about all the different Polynesian cultures.
Yeah.
In the little village, you can like interact with Tongans and Samoans and what are the ones from New Zealand?
New Zealanders?
old, but there's an, it's like the name of the people.
I don't remember.
Artori or something like that.
Yeah, that sounds close.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Where they do the ball, because they do these, this ball. Like it almost looks like you're juggling balls, but they're on strings.
Yeah, the twirly balls.
That's what they're called, but.
Yeah. Yeah. New Zealand twirly balls.
What else did we see? What other villages?
Hawaiian.
Yeah. I don't remember them all. But like smaller people.
They're all students from all the PCC is their employees are students from Brigham Young, which is right. Right down the street here, down the street. And so they give them like a break on tuition if they work at the PCC when they're not like going to class and stuff. So,
Do they?
Yeah. That's what one of them told me.
And we're coming up on the Mormon temple up here. It's big.
Yeah, the massive Mormon temple is coming up here too.
A lot of Mormons at Wine.
Yep.
But we're in Leie. And there's a place called Leie Point. I think you can jump off of it. If anybody's seen the movie Forgetting Sarah Marshall, and there's a scene where they jump off of Leie Point. You can go up there. I wouldn't recommend jumping off of it because I don't know about the safety.
Would you recommend for?
Disclaimer, I'm not recommending it.
Would you recommend Forgetting Sarah Marshall?
Not bad either.
Okay. All right, we are in the shrimp truck park. It's not just shrimp truck. There's some Thai.
This is Koku, and then there's a lot of different things here.
There's a little tacos Mexicanos.
I think it's Mexicano.
There's a lot of food trucks around here. There's several little food truck parks on this strip where there's just kind of just random food trucks. This one's way back here. Looks like it might be out of business. But we're gonna hunt down Johnny's corn. I mean, it is a food truck, so it could have literally driven off.
It's a stand.
Oh, it's a stand? Well, that's less likely that it disappeared, but still. Here's Johnny eating her corn. We got
it's
it.
It's good. It's fresh.
That's good. What's on it?
There's a little corn truck stand. It's behind Giovanni's, which is one of the most popular.
That's Giovanni's. Trucks.
Mm-hmm. Butter, salt, garlic, pepper.
Mm-hmm.
It's just simple, but it's good.
Mm-hmm.
Because the corn's really fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay. Fresh corn. Mm-hmm. All right.
Ryan won't eat any because he doesn't like corn.
Hey, I'm not a huge corn fan.
You don't even want a bite?
Nope. Don't want a bite. All right. Now we're going to go get some more food.
Here we go.
That's not where you want to go surfing.
Look at that big rock out there. It's pretty though.
But there is surfing ahead. You can see people in the water out there. I missed it, but they were in the water.
If you're on this drive and you come to a complete stop at this part, you've made it to Laniakea Beach, which is also called Turtle Beach sometimes. And it's often where you will see sea turtles down there. We can't see it because it's too steep, but yeah, there's probably sea turtles down there because I see a lot of people gather around and signs. They'll put signs up that say like, don't touch the turtles and things like that. But basically like traffic comes to a standstill at points because people are like parking here across the street and trying to walk across to see the sea turtles. So that's what's happening.
It's actually not that busy here, probably because of the waves.
Mm-hmm.
Normally that parking lot would be really full. There's a lot of boats.
The waves are pretty, though, to watch. They're just big.
Fun to watch, not fun to be in. But in front of us here, you've got the entrance into historic Haleiwa. Lots of surf shops.
Surf lessons.
Yep. I always like this bridge here. It's really pretty looking. If you're into like bridge architecture, this is a fun little bridge area. Made in 1921, this bridge. Haleiwa Joe's. The original Haleiwa Joe's. Let's see if you can grow. So it's kind of just real laid back. Little shave ice place here. Of course, the famous shave ice place of Haleiwa Joe's.
No, not just Haleiwa. Hey, they put a Teddy's in.
I mean, if Haleiwa is
Ryan, this is Ryan's favorite burgers.
Yeah. Is it was in this one of these M Yoshida shops, Matsumoto. Oh yeah, it's still there. It's right there on the right. So the most famous, probably the most famous shave ice place is M Matsumoto's grocery store shave ice, which is right here to the right. A lot of times there's really long lines in there to get shave ice. It's pretty good. It's not bad. They got a whole little park in there now.
Yeah. See. So. Oh, an Island Vintage Coffee. There's a lot of new stuff up here.
Yeah, it looks like they've really developed a lot of this. I know they a lot of the stores were moving locations when we lived here. Like they had signs up saying they were closing down and moving to a different spot, a different location. Like Matsumoto's in a different spot now. So I'm guessing they're probably doing some development, trying to redo some of the buildings and stuff.
Yeah, because they look newer. A lot of them look newer.
So, it's pretty nice. But this is a cool little park. People come down here, park, hang out for the day, get something to eat, get some shave ice, do some shopping. Go look at the monster waves on the beach.
Little surfers.
Yeah, that's a fun little part of the island. Historic. Haleiwa on the North Shore.
Alright, so we've left Haleiwa and we both had lunch and they were yummy.
Yep.
Ryan had, tell them what you had.
I had a fish and shrimp po' boy.
From that Cajun guy. It's actually pretty good food, all pretty authentic.
It was very good.
He's a guy from New Orleans, moved out here. And I had some butter garlic shrimp at Mackey's Shrimp Truck. Because that's what you do on the North Shore. Unless you're Ryan and you get grossed out about licking fish legs. I mean, shrimp legs.
Shrimp leg. Man, that was disgusting.
Alright, so now this little area that we're driving up to is called Waialua. And there is a coffee farm up here, but they also have really good shave ice with that uses
coffee.
They use like natural syrups, like so it's like real fruit syrups and stuff, not just the sugary.
Like, and they put
fake stuff.
And they put coffee in it.
Yes, he is looking forward to a coffee shave ice. So there's a couple little shops up here too. It used to be a sugar area.
Yeah, it's
right?
A sugar.
Like a sugar mill.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Waialua. It's just really small and it's kind of like a little jut off the road. on your, if you were coming, like if you were coming from the west side and you were coming up to Haleiwa, and you drove by like the road that takes you by Dole and stuff,
99.
You would get to this area first. So anyway, welcome.
Home of the world's best sugar.
Welcome to Wailua, home of the world's best sugar.
So we got our shave ice, and we finished it off, somewhat. I threw half of mine away. It was just too rich. It was really good, but I was already really full. I was kind of just wanting to get a taste of it. So now we're done with Wailua.
Finished the rest.
And I did drink the rest of Johnny's. It was pineapple and lilikoi. It was really good. But it was a little lighter, easier to drink than my dark chocolate coffee combo. So where are we headed now, Johnny?
Back to the resort.
Back to the resort. If you, what would you say the country is like that we're driving through here?
Isn't that coffee trees?
No.
Cocoa trees?
Those are macadamia nut trees.
Macadamia nut trees. Some kind of trees.
What? Well, how would you describe the country we're going to be driving through on our return trip?
It's open.
Uh-huh.
Like this, just kind of open.
Yeah. Massive trees on all sides.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But open otherwise.
We'll go through pineapples.
Uh huh.
We'll see Dole on the left.
Yep. Dole pineapple.
You can take a train ride to see the pineapple fields.
Mm hmm.
You can do a maze.
Mm hmm.
You can get Dole Whip. You can buy pineapple everything.
This is all at Dole, by the way. This isn't just along the drive back.
No, that's all at Dole. But we can't. We're not going to stop there today.
No, we're not going to stop there. We've done it before. I like the maze, but Johnny doesn't like it.
The maze is okay, but it's kind of
but
hot.
It's pretty much a lot of this, though, for the next, like, I don't know, hour.
Open fields.
A lot of open fields. A lot of farmland. You can see out there, they're got the soil primed and ready to go for something. But the left, I'm pretty sure are macnut trees, because usually those big tall trees that are in front, those are the wind barriers for macnut trees are like really susceptible to wind, and they can't handle a lot of high winds, and the winds can like blow really hard across this big open area in between the mountains. So they plant those big tall trees to shield all the mac trees.
But who would be farming macnut?
Like, I don't know, like one of the 10 companies that sells magnets.
Well, there's not one here.
There's not one here. Hawaiian Host is based on Oahu right now.
Well, I mean, like, there's not one up here that I know of.
Well, maybe it's a local farm and they sell their nuts to someone else.
Maybe.
I don't know. If you know what kind of trees those were, and if there are macnut trees, if you know whose trees they are, if they're your trees, please post in the comments below and let us know so that we can give you proper credit. But anyway, so this is just kind of the drive. It's going to look like this, so I won't film a lot, but just so you guys know. Different part of the island, different climate. Definitely this is the place where you grow stuff. A lot of this has been cleared, I'm pretty sure. I don't know the history. I don't want to say that for sure because I don't know, but it looks like it's been cleared. I mean, obviously the fields where they're planting things have been cleared.
We're in a big giant,
so you can
like
see
a plain.
Yeah.
Because those are the Waianae Mountains.
Yeah.
And then over here is the, what are those called?
I don't know. The Kualas?
Yeah. Kualas?
Kualas?
Mountains.
Yeah.
So we're kind of in this big plain.
Yeah, there's a bus stop. So, yeah, but it's just a bunch of this, so we probably won't be really anything to see until we get back to H1. And when we get to H1, y'all have already seen that. So probably the next time we'll catch up with you is at the resort when we either get done hanging out in the pools or go do something else that y'all haven't seen before. But the plan is to go to the resort, get in the pools, hang out. We may or may not get cleaned up and go to Zippy's, depending on how we feel. We may just hang out at the resort. So, probably also will depend on how hungry we get. And I don't know. We'll see. But anyway, so that's the plan. So we'll see you guys. We'll catch up with you here in a little bit later tonight. All right. Back in the lazy river. Johnny should be coming out of this volcano thingy here in just a second.
Hey, nobody's got a tooth?